So what about processing, this programming language we're going to be learning here? Well, it got started about 2001. That's when two gentlemen by the name of Casey Reyes and Ben Fry started working on the project. Since then, they've gathered a community of developers that have helped them expand the project and eventually get to a 1.0 release in 2008. And since then, we've just recently had a 2.0 release of the software. So it's been growing. It's been growing a lot in interest. But it might not be a language that you're familiar with. It's not really one of the more well-known and widely adopted programming languages out there for commercial development. I think really the purpose behind processing is summed up best in this quote that I found in one of my readings. We created processing to make programming interactive graphics easier. So that idea that graphics is really at the core, is at the foundation of what processing is all about. That's not necessarily the case in a language like C or Java or C++. And so they talk about how they were frustrated with the type of stuff that they wanted to do with interactive graphics was hard to do in C++ and Java in this quote here. And then they were inspired to by the simple languages they learned as kids growing up, Logo and Basic. I mean, myself, I have fond memories of learning basic programming on that the computer time that we had back in K through 12 school. But since then, it's grown, and like I said, into a large community of developers who have added a lot of features to it. And you can get processing by going to their website. That's processing.org. Okay, you'll notice it's a .org, not a .com. That tells you that this is a nonprofit organization. So on their website, processing.org, you'll see a couple different examples. As I said, this is a nonprofit organization, so you'll see some evidence of that here as we go to download processing. If you click on the download processing link, the first thing you're going to come to is a donate option here. You don't have to give a donation to download the software, just to be clear, but it is a good idea to think about making a donation if you end up liking the software and you end up using it quite a lot, to think about making a donation. Then you'll be able to hit the download link, and that's where you can actually pick your platform. If you're a Windows user, you want to pick one of the options over here. If you're on Mac OS X, you're going to pick this option over here. And if you're Linux, there might be someone out there in the class that's taking it using Linux. That's also supported as well. Once you've downloaded it and gotten it installed, I'm a Mac user, so I actually have to go down here to my dock and I'll see an icon that looks something like this. I imagine this icon looks pretty similar on a Windows computer as well. But if you go ahead and launch it, okay, you're going to see a little window pop up, and that's where you're going to actually build your sketches. Okay, this is the window for you to type in your program, your code, in order to actually get started programming with processing. And you notice by default it's just going to name it Sketch. Sketch is just the generic name for the files that processing creates. And then it tags on this what seems like maybe a strange set of numbers here, but it's actually there's a purpose to these numbers. 14 is the last two digits of the year, 6 is the month, and 04 is the date. Okay, so you can actually tell that I'm programming this thing on the 2014. It's June, it's the 4th of the month, and that's when I'm actually creating this. And if I open up new ones from that, it's going to continue using the date and just change the letter at the end, basically. This is more really to save yourself from having an untitled sketch and not having it saved. It is a good idea to go ahead and save your sketch pretty early on, just so that it's backed up on your hard drive. And I'm going to go ahead and save it here to my lesson here. And if nothing else, it'll save it as this unique sketch name that you've started here. But I'm going to do, let's see, demo one. Okay, great, nice generic name. Okay, and I can actually start typing code in here. We've looked at a few examples, and I've assigned some other videos from better sources than I could come up with, that I could produce myself probably, on getting you started on the code. But if we just type in a few lines, okay, I can very easily create a sketch, okay, and I'll just do an ellipse at 100, 100, and I'll make it 50 by 50, okay. So just typing in these 3 lines of code, okay, I've now got a sketch that should draw a black square that I then put a white ellipse on it that's 50 pixels wide and 50 pixels high, okay. Once I've typed in my code, I can go ahead and I can save it, just with a keystroke. I can also then run it. That's this play button right here. There's also a way to get at it right here, okay? And if you're interested in running in a full screen mode, you can do this present option as well. But I tend to just click this play button. It causes the window to pop up and it draws the sketch for me. I can move it to the side and kind of reflect on changes that I've made to the code. But that's pretty much it for writing code and running code. I can hit stop to close it. I can also, once I've opened it up, I can actually get to it right here, quit. Okay. But it's a pretty simple interface that you have in this program, and it should be, even if you're on a Windows or a Linux machine as opposed to my Mac machine, it should look pretty similar to this. And that's the processing interface that we're going to be using for most of our assignments.